Hi, welcome back to Mike's Diabetes World. So, we're ready to go? Sorry, I wasn't ready to go. Current blood sugar is at 7.3. I have 3.050 units of insulin current. I'm currently in a calibration mode. Though it's starting to wane, by lunch we'll be raring to go. Did have one calibration, gave twice insulin for breakfast, but that was because I got a high carb meal. And the first one was the 52 units of grams of carbs they normally give, and this was the extra 30. So, who knows? Everything is working well. Okay, let's go on to the next one. Current blood sugar is at 85% current blood sugar. Time in range is at 85%. So that means 15% is above 85%, and then below 3.9 is zero. The average sugar is a pretty good number, is 7.7. Though I think it went up a bit from 7.2 earlier. This morning, I want to discuss when your blood sugars are too high and how it affects your health. So stay tuned, we'll be right back and we'll get ready to go. This channel is provided for informational purposes only. Contact your physician for any diagnostic or treatment plan. Okay. Every type 1 diabetic knows what DKA feels like. In fact, we all pretty well went through some form of DKA when we were first diagnosed. And as such, we learned how to adapt. We were treated. We were taught how to give insulin. And things probably were wonderful for the first while. What do you mean, Mike? I don't know. What does he mean? Hey, Mike, what do you mean? Well, some people, if they have a really intense low, will say, I don't want to have a low ever again. And they pretty well will cut back their insulin so that their blood sugar is always higher. This is not a good idea. While some insulin may needed to be cut back a bit, cutting it back as drastically as people do, they either cut it back or they decide that it's not really working for them. So what are we going to do about it? Well, first of all, you're not going to let it bother you. It's funny how people seem to think that that is going to be the best solution for everything. It isn't. And while I say some insulin may need to be cut back, people seem to, if they had low, will go and they will cut back the insulin really high so that they won't have to feel the low again. Oh, I don't like how I feel when I'm low. Oh, I don't like how I feel when I'm high. But they'd rather be high than they'd be low. A lot of doctors or medical professionals will say, well, at least you're high than low. That's a better situation to be in. And for me, no, it isn't. Because I want to make sure I have a long life. And with you saying that, doesn't make me feel any more comfortable. While cutting back some insulin to be a little bit higher is wonderful, but it isn't the only thing you need to do. You could have a little bit more food. You could cut back your insulin, but not as drastically as you may think. If you had a severe low and you really are feeling negative about it, you need to speak to your doctor, your endocrinologist. Come up with a plan that will work. Don't just assume that your blood sugar is going to drop so low all the time. If you've watched this channel a number of times, you know that there are so many variables that can fall into place for you to have a high or a low. So the number one reason why diabetics are usually run a higher baseline is because they don't want the fear of dropping again. Well, shouldn't we just leave it that way, Mike? If they're comfortable at it, and the answer is, let me think on this one. No! Sorry, just a little dramatic acting. Terrible dramatic acting. And I'll tell you why. First of all, if you run your blood sugars higher than they should be, chances are you're going to get complications forming. Now, this is something I've always believed, and I don't have any backing on this whatsoever, is some people will get complications while others won't. And it's not because, oh, well, I think you can get it and you can get it, but you'll be safe. No, in fact, what it will be is you may be prone to some sort of issues, and the higher blood sugars just allow it to happen. And like I said, sometimes it may not even be acceptable. So you need to be alert, and you need to know where your doctor actually expects your blood sugars to be in. A lot of us don't bother asking. We just, oh, well, he won't mention. When your doctor says, well, your body's blood sugar or your blood sugar was a little out of range, that's saying something you're doing isn't working correctly and we should take a look at it. He or she is expecting feedback from you. And if you're not able to offer the feedback, the only one that's going to hurt is you. And you need to be aware of this. Don't let your blood sugar go super high. First of all, from a person who did it for years, you're going to be tired. You're going to be exhausted all the time. And it's kind of like a tired you can't shake. You'll come home from school, from work, and have to take a nap more than likely. Because you're tired, you're going to be irritable. That's just the surface. You could cause damage to your heart, your lungs, your stomach, your eyes. Sorry, I knew there was another one. But I don't want to sit here and do the whole thing where, oh, if you don't control your blood sugars, you'll go blind. Because I don't think that's what you really want to tell people. You need to be aware of what will happen. And trying to keep your blood sugars within the 3.9 to 10 or the 70 to the 180 mark will help your body not settle on being okay with complications. You don't want any complication. There are diabetics who have been living on this earth who have never had a complication. And great job on them. There will also be people who will watch their blood sugars and think they're safe. But complications can show their ugly head then as well. But keeping your blood sugars high is just sort of saying, here, like a plant. If you let a plant, you plant two plants. One, you give fertilizer and food, and the other one, you don't do anything to. The one that food and you're eating so much and you're trying to drink will flourish and your complications could flourish. The other one, if you put outside without food or water, chances are the plant's going to die. And this, I personally feel, will come in the form of complications. Don't go high. Yes, complications are terrible, but not everyone will get them. But why live on the edge? Because there are people who say, you know, gee darn dash, I was so glad I got a complication. No, in fact, they'll be spending more time because they have complications. I think my early years as a diabetic, I think my lifestyle kind of added to the situation, but I don't think it was the only cause. Things like I've had neuropathy, complication, I have internal issues, digestion issues. Gee, complication. I have Charcot foot, which has to do with the nerves and blood flow. Oh, wait, what is that again? Complication. Don't let yourself fall into the category. Keep your blood sugars between 3 and 9, or whatever range your doctor wants you to keep them at, and do your best. One blood sugar isn't going to mean you're going to lose your sight, but an ongoing higher blood sugar could cause problems with your legs, with your eyes, with your... The list can go on and on. Don't let it happen to you. And with that, have a great day. We'll talk again soon. Bye now. My email is mikesdiabetesworld@gmail.com. mikesdiabetesworld@gmail.com.